Hey, what's up? What's going on? It's your girl, Mary Jane. Please like, comment, subscribe to my YouTube channel. It would be greatly appreciated from the bottom of my heart, my peace, my peoples. So let's talk about Miami Wax Season 2, Episode 7, Hurricane Phyllis 2, Season Finale. So let's get into it. I also want to thank everybody for watching the videos and rocking with me, hitting that like button and hitting that share button. I really do appreciate it. And also commenting. Thank you. So anyways, we're going to start off with Darnell Dockett. He is out with Darnell. They're playing pool, and basically Darnell is good at pool, and you know, they make a little friendly bet. He says if he wins, you have to cook him something to eat, and he gets to pick out what she wears. And he says if she wins, that he's going to give her a trip to the spa. Uh-oh. And so anyways, it seems like, you know, Darnell Dockett has a big penis, and Darnell was like, oh my goodness, I am so blessed with this, because, you know, most guys that are big and as strong and as tall as he is don't really be packing it down below. But we don't know if that was really his penis or the pool ball that he was trying to hide because he was cheating, trying to win. So we'll see what happens between Darnell Dockett and Darnell, if they are going to last. So anyways, we move on to Kayla and Faven. Kayla and Faven are going to meet up and do some meditation, and Faven thinks it's weird. She's like, you know, I'm a type of person that likes to talk, you know, not all this other stuff. So they look into each other's eyes, they stare at each other, and they're doing some type of meditation. And Faven was like, I'm thinking about dinner, I'm thinking about my kids, I'm thinking about this, I'm thinking about that. And so moving on from that, you know, after the meditation session is over, Faven was like, can I have a minute of your time, Kayla? Kayla was like, yes, we need to talk. Kayla was like, I don't know where we went wrong at. I don't know what happened between us. You know, after we had that little argument or whatever, it just seems downhill, whatever. I don't know what the problem is. And so Faven is like, well, the problem is that you're fake, you're a flip-flop. You don't, it seems like you don't know who you are, that you're not real. And it's like, just be yourself. You know, it seems like you change up, you change for people or whatever. So that kind of does make sense. And then also at the end of the episode, Kayla does also say that, you know, she's tied up pulling the wool over everybody's eyes, pretending like her marriage was perfect with Eric and they were getting along wonderfully and everything was great. And now she can actually be her real self, and, you know, she's getting a divorce from Eric. So there we go. And then we get Matisha. She meets up with Hensha, and they're at the salon. Let me tell you about the salon. The stylist that who was doing, you know, Hensha's hair, he didn't barely spray anything in her hair. He didn't know how to fluff it up. He didn't know how to touch it. He didn't know what to do with it. He was just lost. He was just in the scene, just patting her hair. He was just patting it. He wasn't pushing it. He wasn't trying to separate it, because Hensha said, just make my hair more big and more taller. And he gets a bottle of some type of spray, and he's not picking it out. He's not poofing it out. He's not doing anything. He's just in the scene getting a picture. And also the guy that was doing, you know, Matisha's hair, I don't know how he was curling her hair. He seemed like he was lost too. So I know not to go to that salon. They don't know how to do hair like mine. So anyways, in the conversation, they all talking, and then, you know, Hensha brings up that, you know, she and Daryl was at a podcast, and I mean, Darnell was at a podcast, and then Darnell Dockett came in, her and Darnell Dockett and Darnell have some type of, you know, chemistry, and they're going to be hooking up, and they've been dating or whatever. So then Matisha was like, oh my goodness, I know Darnell Dockett. I used to go out with him. I went out with him on like 3 or 4 dates or whatever, but, you know, it wasn't really that serious. It's not really a big deal. Hensha was like, well, you need to tell Darnell what happened, because I think she should know. That's the best thing to do, because she is your friend. You should talk to her. You should tell her. Matisha's like, no, I don't want to tell her. I don't want to mess up anything. They have something going on right now, and I don't want to be like I'm an interference and coming in and messing up their relationship. Matisha feels like, you know, if she would have known sooner, she would have told her before, but now they're in a relationship and they're happy, and she doesn't want to interfere with that. And, you know, she also says that Darnell should come and talk to her if she has an issue or if she wants to talk about it. But then again, how the hell would Darnell know that you slept with, you know, Darnell Dockett? So it seems like, you know, Matisha doesn't really want to have this conversation with Darnell. She wants to keep this like a little secret. And also, it actually makes her entertaining for the season finale. And this episode, she has got more camera time, and she has been like, you know, the topic of half of the episode. So it's a good look for her. So that's probably why that she didn't want to tell her. And plus, she can carry, you know, the story out to where, you know, it goes. And also, maybe she might be feeling a little jealous, or she just feels like uncomfortable saying, hey, I slept with him, now you're dealing with him, whatever it is. And if she's not comfortable with, you know, Darnell dating Darnell Dockett, even though it's like 2 years ago, because she used to be with him, but everyone's saying that she smashed and she had sex with him or whatever. So maybe she's feeling weird about, you know, that as well, and now have to confront and tell, you know, Darnell. But yet she tells, you know, Hensha, and she also tells Faven about the situation with Darnell Dockett, but she did not tell, you know, Darnell herself, which is her friend, and they talk, and they've been knowing each other for a few years now, but she doesn't feel comfortable in telling her. She doesn't want to tell her. Or is she feeling a little jealous? Or is she feeling a little insecure? Or does she wish it was her? So why does she just feel so uncomfortable in telling her, but she can tell everybody else, which she knows is going to get back to Darnell? She's been on this show for a long time, and she has been involved in drama before. So she doesn't tell it. So Matisha said, she just said, like, it's too late, I don't want to bring it up. So anyways, you know, Darnell and Hensha meet up, and they started talking, and Hensha tells, you know, Darnell what was the situation. She tells Darnell, hey, listen, Matisha used to smash, you know, Darnell Dockett, but she doesn't want to tell you or whatever. And I told her it's the right thing to do. She should tell you, but she doesn't want to. And I don't know why she doesn't want to, but she just feels uncomfortable in telling you, or she wants you to bring it up to her. And so Darnell was like, how the hell do I supposed to know who she slept with, who she spread her legs around with, who she was with? So how am I going to know? You know, and if she hears me talking about him, or she knows that I am dating him and she's been with him, all she has to do is just tell me. You know, she don't have to keep it to herself. But anyways, they're going to leave that alone until next time. So, you know, Darnell's feeling like, yo, why don't she want to tell me? Is she jealous about the situation? Or does she feel like she's holding something over my head? Why? Like, we friends, like, we cool. Why not tell me? So Fava, Matisha, Darnell, and Hensha, they meet up for drinks or whatever. And so now they get to have drinks or whatever, meeting up for dinner. And so then Faven also tells Darnell that, you know, Matisha had told her about her smashing, you know, Darnell Dockett or whatever. And so Darnell was like, why is she telling you? She's telling everybody else, but she's not telling me. Not telling me. That doesn't make any sense. And so now Darnell feeling kind of like slighted, and feeling like, you know, what's her name, Matisha, is being shady. Because why, if she doesn't feel, she wants Darnell to bring it up to her, but she's telling everybody else, but she won't confront her and tell her, the person that needs to know it the most. And Matisha could have just went to Darnell, text her, met up with her, it would have been another scene, and then talked to Darnell, tell Darnell what was going on. That's all she had to do, instead of telling everybody else, so everybody else can go back and tell Darnell, so then Darnell can come and confront her. Is it because Matisha doesn't like confrontation, or what is it? Why didn't she want to say anything? So then now Matisha gets played at the table. So they play Matisha at this table, so everyone's chilling, they're having drinks or whatever, and then Darnell, you know, she's kind of like bragging about her and Darnell Dockett, about how he makes her laugh and all this other stuff. But first, Darnell, she tells the ladies that, guess what? Astrid is not coming to, you know, Ashley's wedding. And they all toast. They're all happy. It's all good. And, you know, Hensha was like, I'm so glad I'm going to act up at, you know, Ashley's wedding. You shouldn't act up at Ashley's wedding, whether Astrid was there or not, because you're there for one reason only, and that's to support Ashley. So moving on from that, so now it's Darnell. So Darnell and Faven, they're talking. That Faven is like, yeah, so I know you didn't give him the poo-poo nani yet. And Faven was like, you got strong self-control. You know how to control yourself. And so then that's when, you know, Darnell is talking about, like, yes, I can cook, I can clean, I take care of kids, I can do this, I can do that, but I got the crown jewels, and, you know, I keep that, that's my secret weapon, that's the best thing that I got going for me. And it was just like, yo, why are you saying that, Darnell? Like, your vagina is the best thing you got going for you. You know, it's more, and sex is really important in relationship, but you need to have more than just good sex, because if you just only have good sex, believe me, there's somebody down the street and around the corner that got just as good sex as you, and that would do anything else. So you have to have a lot more to offer. You can cook, you can clean, but are you business mind? Are you supportive? Or do you Can you multitask? Are you loving? Are you understanding? Are you down? Different things, that can make you more viable to a person other than just your vagina. Because believe me, if someone just has good, D, doesn't mean I'm gonna stay with them if they got flaws and characteristics that I can't deal with. So, anyways, it seems like this is probably one of the reasons why Darnell has low self-esteem, because she thinks her vagina is the only thing that's going for her, is the best thing that she got. But she could mean it in a different way, that she loves and she takes pride in her vagina and she doesn't just give it away. But in the meantime, and between time, while Darnell is telling the story to, Favren and the other girls, while they're all at the table, Astrid, not Astrid, but Matisha and Hensha, it's like they're throwing shade at Matisha, because then Darnell's also saying that, yeah, my vagina is good, I just don't give it away, that's why the guys come to me, they stay, they don't leave, I just don't be giving it away like it's free, and that's, I got the good stuff, and that's why they want to stick with me and stay with me, and they come after me and they chase me and all this other different stuff that Darnell is saying. And then Matisha, she has in her face all turned up, she's looking all like, okay, because I know Matisha had to feel like they're throwing shots at her, that she just ran around and had sex with Darnell Dockett. He just hit it and quit it just like that. And Darnell's trying to say, well, he ain't gonna hit and quit this, because this is the crown jewel and I'm gonna make him wait. He's gonna be begging for it. He's gonna be waiting for it. And it's gonna, and if you leave something to the imagination and you take your time before you give him the sex, that he would treasure you, basically. That's what Darnell is trying to say and throw up. And Matisha's face, Matisha's feeling some type of way about the situation. So that's when Matisha says to Hensha, hey, listen, so should I say something? Hensha was like, I'm not gonna say anything, it's up to, I'm not gonna say nothing, whatever. And so then Darnell's talking to Faven, telling Faven, hey, listen, look at her over there whispering, she ain't even saying nothing or whatever. And so then Darnell said, I'm just gonna, so Darnell just kind of like confronted the situation. And Matisha, she finally, confronts the situation. And, Hitch was like, yo, you feel uncomfortable about bringing this up, but now you're gonna bring it up at this time. And so then that's when Matisha, she finally brings it up. She goes, I'm sorry. She goes, I felt uncomfortable bringing it up in front of other people, in front of everybody else. This happened like over 2.5 years ago or whatever. I should have talked to you about it, but I didn't. And you're like, I just didn't want to bring it up. And so then that's when Darnell was like, oh, you didn't want to bring it up and you want to wait till we were alone. But yet you brought it up to everybody else. You told Faven, you told Hensha, you told everybody else. But me, how come you didn't tell me? It seems like, that's shady. Why would you not do that? Like, we friends like that. Like, you're trying to hold something over my head in a way. That's how it seems. But it's all good. Darnell, she leaves the table. So does Faven, they both leave the table. And, Matisha is still talking her mess, like, oh, I didn't know. I didn't want to bring it up to anybody. And so Ashton was like, well, you should have said something long time ago, way before. But, it is what it is with the situation. So they leave, and so now we get back to Ash. We get to Ashley and we get to Philip. They're getting ready, they're getting packing for their wedding. And they're practicing kissing and all this other stuff. And then Phil thinks that the wedding planner is responsible for his tuxedo. And so, Ashley's like, no, she's not responsible for your tuxedo. That's you. You got to do that. That's our job. And so, Phil was like, well, I didn't know. I don't know. I never been married before. I never did this before. So that was so cute. And they kiss and they talk about how they should kiss and all this other stuff. And Ashley's about to be a wag. And so we'll see what happens with that situation. So it's just, oh my goodness, they're too much. I don't know why Matisha just feels like she couldn't talk to her and just tell her what was going on, but she didn't. So, and anyways, Darnell, right now she's feeling good about the situation. She's feeling good about, dating Darnell Dockett. She feels like it's a good look, it's a good thing going on right now. And Faven, she's in love with Miami, she loves her job, she, like, Faven, she's doing good, she got it she got it going on right now. And she has She has a support in her team going to, her husband and her are going to stay here in Miami. It's just like, come on, Matisha, how come you didn't tell her? And was Hentia, should Hentia had told Matisha before when she met up with Faven and Darnell that she talked to Darnell about the situation, did tell her about it, and maybe in that type of form that, you know, Matisha would have been comfortable in bringing it up right away at the table. So I don't know if that was a setup or not. You guys tell me what you think about that situation. And so, it's crazy. I don't know. It seems like, you know, she was kind of set up and she was kind of not set up. So we'll see. And, you know, Kayla, so all the girls, they bounce and they're going to the wedding location for, you know, Ashley's wedding. And Kayla ends up talking to Faven to tell Faven that her and Erica are having problems. They haven't seen each other in 2 weeks and all this other stuff. Matisha hasn't showed up yet to the situation. So all the ladies are there, you know. Ashley, she arrives with Phil. It's a beautiful place. It's a beautiful location. They're having a good time. And it seems like everything's going well. And their bedroom looks nice. Everything looks nice. And so all the other ladies in one suite or whatever, they're having a good time. They're talking, they're drinking, they're hanging out. You know, Matisha, she's going to arrive later. And so Kayla, she hasn't seen, you know, Eric in like 2 weeks or whatever. So she ends up telling, you know, what's her name, Faven, what was going on. But anyways, people was like, Faven was like, where's Matisha or whatever. And then, you know, the girl was like, I don't know, whatever. So then that's when Kayla was like, yo, is there a problem? There's something going on with Matisha I don't know about. So the girls let, you know, Kayla in on a secret, like what's going on with Matisha and Darnell or whatever. And so Fava, Hentia, and Kayla, they start talking about the situation with Matisha, but not really that much or whatever. And then Matisha finally shows up. She walks in. Then Darnell acts like she's leaving and she's going to go check on Ashley, see how she's doing. But she didn't leave. She's at the closet place, you know, ear hustling. And so this is when Matisha starts to tell everybody, hey, you know, I thought you girls was mad at me. And the girls was like, we thought you was mad at me. So right now everyone's finding out that they're not mad at each other. So Matisha, she's going on saying that, hey, listen, I didn't want to tell Darnell in front of everybody. I didn't want to tell her why everybody was around. I wanted to tell her privately. And so then that's when Darnell walks back in and she was like, hey, if you wanted to tell me privately and all this other stuff, why did you tell Fabe and why did you tell Hentia everything but you didn't come to me? We're really good friends. We're close friends. We talk about so much stuff. We had so much going on last year. You've seen what I was going through. You've seen all the heartbreak I was going through and everything. So why can you just tell me? She was like, oh, I didn't think it was appropriate. It was at the right time and all this other stuff. And so, you know, she was like, but, you know, it's just like Matisha and her excuse that she should have told her. And then Hentia was like, you know what? See, Matisha, she talks and she runs her mouth. And this time she has to own up for her behaviors and actually own up for what she did. And now she's in trouble when she could have just told her, like I gave her the advice. So Matisha's trying to get herself out of the sandbox and just say, hey, listen, blah, 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 blah. And Darnell's not really trying to hear it. So they're not making up at this time and point now. So then Kayla talks to, you know, Faven, tell Faven that she's separated from Phil. And she was like, she known him for 18 years. They've been best friends. They're not lovers anymore. She was like, I'm 25. I'm not happy. I'm always in Eric's corner. I'm always there for him, supporting him. It doesn't feel like we have an intimate connection, a love connection. It's like we're just friends. I tell him I want to spark it up. I want to have sex. I want to do this. I want to do that. It feels like he's unattracted to me, that he doesn't want to spice things up. When I tell him I want to try something different, do something new in the bed, he just ignores me and everything goes back to normal. And Donna was like, oh my God, I can't believe this. So now Kayla is feeling close to Faven. So her and Faven are having the best of their relationship and growing on each other. Faven says that Kayla's growing on her or whatever. But, you know, it is what it is. If I was Kayla, I wouldn't have been telling my business or whatever. But it's a good thing to tell her business to them so the ladies could feel sorry for her, be her friend, and possibly she can be on the next season. So I guess it is a good look, but they ain't really like friends like that, but she's opening it up to tell them what's going on. And it's like, why is she not talking to Claudia? Because didn't Claudia introduce her to the circle? I guess Claudia ain't nowhere to be found. She's somewhere in North Carolina behind what's his name. I don't know if she's even going to be on next season. So, so all the girls, they leave, they go to the beach or whatever. And, Matisha, she's not there yet. So then she finally comes out. She has a beautiful outfit on, that yellow outfit. She had bathing suits and swimwear, which was really nice. But that outfit would have looked perfect on Ashley. Perfect on Ashley. So anyways, Matisha, she walks up to the ladies and she asks to speak to Darnell. She talks to Darnell and then they make amends. They're friends now. Everything's forgiven. Everything's all good. So that's cool. And so then we get to, you know, Ashley and, you know, her mother-in-law, Miss Phyllis, and Ashley's mother's there. I think her name is Vanetta. I don't know. I can't remember what her name is. So they're getting ready. You know, they're in the spa. You know, Ashley's having a good treatment for these ladies or whatever. And so then, you know, Ashley was like, well, Ashley's mother said, I hope there's no more surprises or whatever, because, you know, she's surprising the mothers with, you know, spa, champagne and everything. And it's a nice treat. And so Ashley goes, there's no more surprises. I ain't pregnant. And then, so that's when Miss Phyllis, she's talking about, oh, I hope you ain't pregnant because I don't think you guys need another child. You can barely handle the one that you got. And it was like, whoa, oh no. Miss Phyllis is hating. She's hating to the full degree. I mean, she's hating. And she was like, you don't need any more kids. Because you know what? You have to get the first one down packed first. Get the first one right. Get the first down packed. Because you guys are not ready for another child. You guys are too busy. Way too busy for another child. And so then the ladies go get their massages. And then the conversation continues to go. And so Miss Phyllis is like, well, you know what, your child felt abandoned. He feels, you know, when I tried to take him to the airport, he didn't want to leave because he didn't want to go home and all this other stuff because you guys ain't around. He feels abandoned. He feels like he's not important. You got, she said so much. And I was like, oh no. And so then, you know, Ashley's mother was just sitting there. She wasn't really saying anything to defend her daughter, but maybe that was a good thing to happen so the wedding could keep going, so the two mothers didn't get into the argument where one would refuse to attend the wedding if some really harsh words were said. But if that was my mom would have totally defended me, and she would have verbally assassinated Mrs. Phyllis, verbally, where she wouldn't have been able to, you know, check out the wedding, you know, check out tomorrow, I don't want to be there, or all this other stuff. But it seems like very fugazi for Mrs. Phyllis to be talking about. She's really saying that her child feels abandoned, that she's really not a good mother. And so then Ashley tries to defend herself, like, oh, my son always does that. Like, he never wants to go home. And so, you know, Miss Phyllis was like, yep, see, that's what I'm talking about. And she was like, why don't he want to go home? Because he don't feel right. He feels abandoned. He feels this. He feels that. And Ashley, like, he always cries. He always does that because he want to go to the park. My son loves me. And so Miss Phyllis is like, I'm not saying that he doesn't love you. The problem is you guys abandon him. You're not there for him. You know, I'm speaking up about how the child feels. I'm not speaking about how I feel, how you feel, how Phil feels. I'm just speaking about the child. The child feels abandoned. And I don't think you should have another child. And she could have a really good point or whatever, but this is not the time or the place to say this. You know, she could call at before the wedding or after wedding and let Ashley know, hey, listen, I think, you know, your son is feeling a certain type of way. I think he might be having some type of abandonment issues, and it might not be that or whatever he's going through, but I maybe, you know, he needs to see you and feel more, or what can I do to help you, Ashley, so, you know, you can spend more time with Phil or with your son or whatever. But she totally went out left field. She was like, I can say anything and everything that I want to say. You know, this is my family. And so Ashley gets all up in her face and was like, I can't believe you saying this, girl, bye. And she was like, yo, don't get in my face with that girl, bye stuff. I ain't your girl. That's what Mrs. Phyllis says. Mrs. Phyllis was not backing down. And Ashley's mother was not stepping up to the plate to defend her child. But I understand why, because it is her child's business and her child's an adult. She's about to get married. And I don't think that she wanted to cause any more confusion that's already going on. So, Oh my goodness. Is Mrs. Phyllis jealous of, Ashley and her wedding, that her son that she gave birth to is actually providing a type of lifestyle that Mrs. Phyllis probably want her husband or her new husband that she's about to marry to do for her? And is she, jealous of what Phil has with her, that she wish she had a man like this, or she wish that Phil was paying for her wedding or whatever, because she wasn't happy with the over 100K spent on the wedding. She wasn't happy with the location and all this other stuff. It seems like she might have a point about saving money, but it's the way that you present your message, and the way that she presents her message come off bitter, comes out hateful, comes out like if she's jealous of Ashley and what Ashley has with her son. But before, Ashley always said that her and Mrs. Phyllis had a good relationship. They got along well. And so what happened? Ashley says after she had the baby, everything had changed. So do you think Mrs. Phyllis felt that, Ashley overstepped her bounds, or Ashley feels like she doesn't need her approval anymore, Mrs. Phyllis' approval anymore, to be with Phil because she done snatched him with the baby? Because I think Ashley is a good woman for Phil. I think they are a good couple, a good, So what are your take on the situation? Is the mother coming off hateful and jealous of the situation? Do she want a man like Phil to pay for her wedding? And it's like she don't like her. Is she well, the way they're filming and producing the show, it seems like Phil's mother doesn't like Ashley, but she might have some valid points that we are not privy to, that we don't know, that goes on privately between Ashley and her husband now and their child, that she's privy to, but she doesn't know how to deliver the message. Or she's just doing this for camera time because she wants to be a part of the show more. She wants to be like one of these reality TV moms that be on these shows acting up. So anyways, moving on from that, I was like, no. So Eric and Kayla, Eric finally shows up to the wedding venue, and Faven and Kayla was talking. Well, Eric is either gonna come, he's either coming here to support Phil, he's coming in to get his marriage together, or try to get Kayla back or whatever, because they've been separated for 2 weeks. But Eric is not coming there to get their marriage together. He's just coming there to support and try to get him some nookie nookie. And it seems like he wanted some nookie nookie from Matisha. He wanted to get into Matisha. He wanted to tear that Latino up. So we'll find out. But we're not gonna find out because I don't think they're gonna hook up unless it's gonna be next season. But Matisha's like she ain't feeling it. So anyways, Eric shows up, Kayla and Eric talk, and they're staying in separate rooms or whatever. They're not staying together, and it seems like their marriage is over. That's what it seems like, the conversation. So anyways, Matisha is having a drink or whatever. She's having a drink. And Matisha's coming out to have a drink. Eric is already sitting at the bar, and they're talking. It seems like they are flirting. He's like, "Oh, so I'm glad you here. I'm glad you was invited. I'm glad you was on the list." After Matisha said, "Hey, look, I like to drink or whatever." So it seems like they were definitely flirting. And oh goodness. So it does seem like, they was definitely flirting. And then Eric was talking about when he was, so then the other ladies joined. So, Faven joins the group, and so does Kayla join the group as well. And I think Kendra was there. She might have been, she might have not been, or whatever. But so anyways, Eric is talking about, "Hey, listen, when I was single, I used to put that jack down on me. It used to make the girls go crazy." And he's looking at Matisha or whatever. And then Eric is showing Matisha his phone. He was like, "Oh, did you see that?" I think that was a dick pic on Eric's phone, and he was trying to show Matisha his dick, in my opinion. I could be very wrong. So Faven and Kayla, they think that Eric is flirting with Matisha. Matisha's flirting with Eric. And Eric's also talking about, oh, they was talking about the suicide girls or whatever. And I was like, "Oh, don't Kayla look like one of the suicide girls?" And then Eric goes, "I wish." No, she doesn't. So then Kayla's feeling embarrassed and she's cringing. She was like, "Well, I wish you looked like this actor." And he was like, "Well, some people do say I do look like him." And so Kayla is just, she's not feeling though. Everybody else is looking like, okay. I think Hencho is there as well. So, and that's when, Kayla, was talking about how she feels like she's not good enough for Eric, that he doesn't really want her. She starts to cry and everything. So we'll see what happens. And so now we're getting wet. Now we're getting ready for the wedding or whatever. And, you know, all the ladies, the bridesmaids, they're getting ready. Ashley's getting ready. Darnell's getting ready. Everything's going perfect. Everything's going good. And so then, Mrs. Phyllis, she walks in and, Ashley was like, hey, you missed the gift giving or whatever. So Ashley goes over there, gives, Mrs. Phyllis a gift, gives her her Michelob beer that she wanted so bad, a robe or whatever. And she gave her a card. So it seemed like Mrs. Phyllis was going to go get up and hug Ashley. And I even think she said it. I might have it in the slideshow. But then she just walks right past, Ashley and goes into the other room and she pays her dust. And, Ashley Donnell was like, well, I thought she was going to, hug me or whatever. Nah, she didn't. She went right into the next room. But not let me forget about the dinner, the rehearsal dinner. And then also Mrs. Phillips was like, I don't want to go to the rehearsal dinner. I don't think that's, we don't need no rehearsal dinner. And so, Ashley was like, well, at your wedding, you might not have a rehearsal dinner, but at my wedding, we're going to have a rehearsal dinner. That's how we're going to do it here. And so Mrs. Phyllis didn't like that either. So anyways, they have the rehearsal dinner, and Ashley Moms gives her a toast, calling her good mother, great mother. And so then that's when Mrs. Phyllis get up and like, my son's a good son, a great son, and a good man and a good husband. And she tells Ashley, well, when you in this family, we speak our mind. We say what's on our mind and we mean what we say or whatever. In so many words, she said, we speak what's on our mind. She gets up and she walks away with her husband. Her mother is, Mrs. Phillips is totally, too much. It seems like she's jealous of her son's happiness and she's jealous that he's happy with Ashley. Like, she wants him to still be a boy. This is his wife, his baby's mother. Like, lady, get it together. If you don't like her, you don't want to be around, you don't want something, anything, then don't show up to the wedding. But don't be a nuisance, don't be a pest, don't come on TV, make your son look bad, make him look like you raised him, you raised him all wrong. But you didn't, because he's getting married and he's having a child. So why do you have to come on this show and make yourself look like a revengeful, jealous, evil woman for no reason? That she carried your grandson. Like, let's get it together, Missy. Unless there's something else going on that we have no idea about. Unless Phil's telling you something else that we don't know about. But other than that, it don't look good. It's not a good look. And I don't know how more Ashley could be nice to you. So, anyways, moving on from that. So, she even got her Michelob beer. Who drinks that? Well, maybe a lot of people do drink it. Okay, because some of you guys that might watch this video might drink Michelob beer. I've never had it before. So, it's crazy. And so, Kayla, she ends up confronting Eric about flirting with Matisha and all this other stuff. He goes, he wasn't flirting with Matisha. And so Kayla was like, Matisha told me that you called her about 12 o'clock. You wanted to meet up. You wanted to talk to her and all this other stuff. And Kayla was like, I thought you was here to save my marriage. Eric could really give two shits about any of this. He does not care, period, point blank, at all. He was like, nah, it's not like that, whatever. Eric is done. I think he's been done with the relationship and he's probably been with somebody else. Because actually when he was at, Phil's bachelor's party, he had all the women on him. And Phil was like, I feel kind of uncomfortable the way, Eric is over here with these ladies. Like, whoa, he's married. Even Phil thought like, hey, so he's been checked out the wedding and he just, filmed with, Kayla to get his name out there, get her name out there and get her a job. So he was like, nah, nah, that didn't happen. It wasn't like that or whatever. And so, we have the wedding. The wedding's beautiful. Ashley looks drop dead gorgeous. It's a beautiful dress. It's just I didn't like the pink lipstick. She needed a different color, a more warm of color on her lip. And they put like too much heavy shimmering on like the side of her cheeks. And they like I should be the last person talking about eyebrows, but they arched her eyebrows too thick and too long going towards her eyes. That really just didn't look normal. It looked like somebody drawed them on, even though we know that her eyebrows were done and it was expensive. But her eyebrows always look perfect. But this particular eyebrow that they did for Ashley, you know, kind of threw off the look with her wedding dress. And then also her hair did look nice. Her hair did look wonderful. But you can also tell that it's a piece on Ashley's hair. They could have did more. But other than that, Ashley looks stunning, drop dead gorgeous. And she's always beautiful. She's like one of the prettiest women on the show. Or she's her and Daryl are like the most beautiful. It's both are the most beautiful women on this show. Like in the looks department, I think they like outshine everybody. And then Hench is next, then Faven, and Claudia somewhere in between, and then whoever. So let me keep going. And so anyways, they get married, and then Eric is talking to Corey, and Eric's talking to Corey like, hey, Matisha's told Kayla that, hey, I was trying to flirt with her and all this other stuff. I was only trying to talk to Matisha to get my head together, get my head right, because, you know, I just needed somebody to talk to. I felt really bad or whatever. And he was like, if I had Faven's number, I would have called Faven and all this other stuff. And Corey was like, oh, this is messed up. I don't know why Matisha's over there talking crap, you know, saying that you was trying to get with her, you was flirting with her or whatever. So it just seems like, you know, so Corey's, you know, sticking up for Eric because him and Eric are cool. And so Corey wants to talk to Matisha because he said he wants to get this bullshit out the way. And so then Faven, Eric, you know, and he talks about, yes, I did text her. I would have texted Faven, but I didn't have her number. So what was I supposed to do? I had a big problem, whatever. So then they're sitting down talking. Then, you know, Matisha, she comes over and she was like, yeah. She was like, yeah, I did tell. She was like, yes, I did tell, you know, Kayla that you call and you text me. And she was like, yes, we were flirting. We were both flirting. So, you know, Matisha admitted that she was flirting with Eric. She said, we were flirting. We both was flirting. You were flirting with me. We were flirting together or whatever. And so, and that's when, you know, Faven comes over. That's when Hensha comes over. That's when Darnell comes over. Then they started to give, you know, Eric the third degree, asking Eric if, you know, what he loves about Kayla, and he couldn't really say what he loved about her. He was trying to get there, but he couldn't. The ladies cut him off. He was just like, yo, I don't really know her. I've been trying to get to know her for 4 years, and I still don't know her that much. But, you know, it takes a long time to get to know somebody, sometimes to know the ins and outs. And sometimes you can learn something new about a person every single day. So, you know, what's her name? And then Darnell jumps in and was like, oh, you can't even say why you love her or this and that. Like, you couldn't even give a clear answer. Then so then Darnell, she goes over to Corey. It's like, Corey, what do you love about, you know, Fave? And he was like, I love this, I love that. And see, he can give a straight, honest answer. A man that's married, that's with his wife or whatever. So it's like all drama filled now. And it doesn't seem like it's going to go anywhere. It's just going to be negativity. So Eric, he's getting tongue-tied. He's getting choke-tied. He don't really know what to say. He's trying to talk. So Corey was like, come on, let's go. Let's go, you know, because we need a drink. I was like, no, let's finish this conversation. You know, Darnell should kind of like mind her business about the situation because she has not been in a good relationship yet. And she just started to date this guy, Darnell Dockett. And she thinks there's going to be wedding bells in the future. She thinks that, you know, it's love. Hopefully it is. But it seems like she hasn't done a lot of work on herself as well. Because now she's just running and jumping towards this guy, Darnell Dockett. And she might be coming off too needy and too desperate and want to get that ring. And I don't know if she's going to counseling or getting counseling to help with, you know, the low self-esteem she does have. And also deal with the pain and hurt that she has suffered from Rashid, so she don't bring that baggage to a new relationship, because it's like she's thinking it's wedding bells already. So that situation's over. It seems like, you know, Kayla shouldn't let these women that she barely even know get into discussion with her husband about their marriage or what's going on. You know, Kayla should have talked to him privately. She did talk to him privately, but, you know, it wasn't, she didn't bring the girls into the situation. He was downstairs. He was talking to Corey about it. Faven came over, you know, Matisha came over. So it's not really Kayla's fault, but it's not a good look. I would have been like, come on, let's change the subject. And so I know Matisha, she finally just got herself out of the, you know, out the darkness with the situation with Darnell. Now she's involved with somebody else's situation. And I also want to bring up when Darnell was bragging about how good, you know, Darnell Dockett is and how he makes her feel. I don't know if that was a good thing to be saying that around Matisha and say that around Hensha, even though they are friends or whatever. But, you know, you never tell a bunch of women about how good your man is and all this other stuff, because then they're gonna want some of that, especially Matisha. And we already know Hensha would jump on something, she'll jump on Astrid, man, but I don't know if she'll jump on Darnell's man because her and Darnell are close. So, but anyways, keep your business to yourself with your relationships, because you don't know if the people really there for you or if they might jump on what you got because they want what you got. They like the way he treats you. So anyways, that's over. They cut the cake, they dance, and they're having a good time. You know, what's her name? Darnell, she catches the bouquet, or she picks up the bouquet off the floor, and then she immediately calls Darnell Dockett to let him know she caught the bouquet, because she's trying to send him signals that she wants to be married, which is another, you know, kind of desperate, clingy thing to do. But hey, it might work. At least she's being real about what she wants, but it might come off not too good. Or he might hit it and quit it like he did Matisha. So don't get on your mighty high horse, my friend. But anyways, I hope it does work out. I hope he doesn't hit it and quit it. So then we get to Hensha tells, you know, Darnell that she believes that she might be pregnant and all this other stuff. So then they take a pregnancy test, and Hensha is pregnant. She's having a baby. And I thought the baby was going to be Michael's, the guy that Astrid was going to date, but it's not his baby. She says it's a good friend of hers, a friend, and she don't know how to tell him or whatever, and she's crying. You know, Darnell's there to support her, to tell her, hey, I got your back. Hensha don't know what to do, but we do find out that Hensha ends up having a miscarriage. I don't know if she actually had an abortion or a miscarriage, because on these reality TV shows, they say abortion for miscarriage, or they fake their pregnancies, you know, for storylines. But I'm not saying Hinch is doing it, but it is a possibility. And no one's going to be pulling the wool over my eyes or your eyes either, or my peeps' eyes or whatever. So basically, that's it. So Hensha had a miscarriage, and Kayla is going to be divorcing Eric. Faven's going to stay in Miami, and she loves it. And, you know, Ashley and Phil, they talk about the situation with the wedding and with his mom or whatever. And he was like, are you going to come to my mom's wedding? She was like, of course I'm going to come to your mom's wedding or whatever. I'm going to say hi and bye, two words only. So they're going to try to work that situation out. And Hensha is not pregnant, so she's going to protect herself and use protection, I guess, more. And, well, at least Astrid, you know, she ain't coming up with no babies, but nor is Hensha now. And we'll see what happens with the situation. We'll see what happens next season. Anyways, I'm out. Peace.